As you approach me, you may find that this is the Queen Mary engine room and the Queen Mary zone. Stay tuned for us to show you more history. We are back on the Queen Mary zone, and I am showing you things that you probably have not seen, such as a blown up inside of the Queen Mary. Follow me as I show. You see the beautiful cabins and the insides that still stand. Queen Mary started sailing in 1934. 1967 was sold to the Long Beach port. It now stands here as a museum. And it is rumored to be haunted.
We are back in the apocalypse at the Queen Mary lot. I went into a Rod Serling phase, and I am back as myself. As you can see, this is a very, very intricate ship. And you can still come to Long Beach to see it. So come hither. We are looking for Charlie Chaplin's portrait. I did find Victor Mature.
Right now. Outside, you will leave the ship and go into the ship at the bow section there. And you will end up on the beach. In the afternoon, this became a movie theater. Projectors were behind the cutouts. The screen would have filled up the stage. We were having a World's Fair in Paris. Avec les dons, we called it the Art Deco. La mer. The Queen Mary today is the Art Deco capital of the West Coast. We're going to be functioning here in the fall to celebrate. The theme of this room is given by the bronze room over the stage, the doors, sides, the place, the guest of panel here. The music. Also, last week they were making one of those reality shows.
This is called Piccadilly Circus.
See something that interests you, make a mental image, find it in the market. Left, right, and south. There are these market reports all over the place. Each one is dealt with. If you've ever tried it, across the lake smoking. Yes. It's fast. That is not as everything else. Queen Mary's three libraries were the first ones in the world with this braille setting. Avec les ombres si pures, la mer, bergère d'azur.
Who loves you, baby?
Des étangs, des grands.
That was the observation. This is the Maritime room. This is considered third class. Back in those days, people used to look at things. Third class people, they couldn't afford. They used to write down the name and give it to the steward. Hence, window shopping.
So they filmed Godfather 2. They're gonna do Titanic. They already did Titanic 2 on the boat. What are they doing? On the sci-fi channel, they did a lot of
things. Trying to get more kids on the ship, they did this ghost and legend show. The highest compliment ever paid this ship was made by
Sir Winston Churchill when he spoke to Queen Mary and her sister ship, the Queen Elizabeth, and the part they both played in the successful outcome of the war. I want to read you a little bit of his beautiful speech that he said to the world about these two ships, the men who sailed in, and of course the men aboard them. He said, "Built for the arts of peace and to link the old world with the new, the Queens challenged the fury of Hitlerism to defend the liberties of civilization. Vital decisions depended on their ability continuously to elude the enemy, and without their aid, the day of final victory must unquestionably have been postponed. To the men who contributed to the success of our operations, the world owes a debt that will not be easy to measure." Beautiful speech. Any of you fathers, grandfathers, anybody? Just me? The Queen Mary would travel over 600,000 miles, transport over 800,000 troops, and play a major role in virtually every Allied campaign of World War II. Daunted by the combined forces of Germany, Italy, and Japan, she was never attacked, never fired her guns in anger, and most importantly, never lost a single passenger to enemy action. It's an amazing feat, don't you think, for a ship this big in a major war for 7 years. William J. Duncan, author of Queen Mary, Queen of Queens, his book in 1969, said she was a ship that survived a depression, a war, and a scrapyard. You see, in the 60s, our parents and grandparents, mine anyway, said, "Let's fly over to Europe. We don't need to take these beautiful ships anymore and be totally spoiled and pampered. Let's get over there." Her last voyage in 1967, she only had 467 passengers. She's losing a fortune. The story actually says that Cunard was going to sail the Queen Mary out to sea and sink her. But they got 30 bids from countries all over the world saying, "Don't do that, we'll buy her." Long Beach, of course, submitted the highest bid, which to me sounds like nothing today, of $3,450,000, and this ship became the property of Long Beach.
All the way down to the end of this unnecessarily dark
hall. So many treasures here. I cannot show you what lies behind these doors. So stay attuned.
I'm hungry.
Personal spaces on the steps here by the entrance to this room. Try to squeeze the entire window of security and make room for everyone. Welcome.
Can you see it?